singers around town who would just come in and sing this song with you and let's see if it's right. And now I had heard Joy singing all of our marriage at home when she was happy. And she sounded pretty darn good to me. So I said, gee, my wife sings, I'll bring her in, let's do it. I just need a girl's voice. Well, Joy came in and the guy said, she's it, she's got the job. She's gonna be the duet, the other side of the duet. So Joy sang on the first song, first album that we did a couple of years ago, and she was a sensation. The next really? Album, we did a Christmas album, and Joy got two of those songs. Now, on this particular album, we're gonna sing all duets. All duets. See how these things go, how things grow? And as I told the guys in the band, next year, Joy's gonna have her own album. And I'm gonna be the drummer. So really, that's how it started. And I know that, Joy, you could tell us, did you always want to be a singer? You never really thought of it. You played the piano.
Well, yes, you know, I grew up around music, and my mother was a wonderful, wonderful pianist. In fact, you know, she was so popular because people would ask her if she was available before they'd have a party. And people would just call out songs, and she could play anything. So she said to me, if you really, really want to have a wonderful life, learn how to play the piano. It's a great thing to know. So I did. I started studying when I was about 8 years old. And I found that what I really liked to do was just to sit down and sing and accompany myself. And then I realized that, you know, through the years, I learned a lot that way. And of course, I grew up with Edie Gourmet and Sarah Vaughan and, you know, all those great singers.
And
Bing Crosby. And I think that when Regis asked me, of course, I thought, what an opportunity to just have the thrill of standing there in a recording studio, but I never dreamed that it would end up, that we would do this whole album together. It was a really a joyous experience. I spent the whole summer in a recording studio, a little, you know, above Broadway, and I loved every minute of it. And I thank you for the opportunity. And now let me tell you, when I was born in Chicago on the South Side.
This is going to be a long story. Don't tell me your aunt had an apartment house.
I'm only kidding. I don't think that would be very interesting, but thank you for renewing and refreshing my memory on your early beginnings. That was it's really great.
Anyway, this summer, the guys who backed us in the first two albums, Alan Salzberg, right over here, and John Colbert, right over there.
And Marty Berman.
And Marty Berman is our producer. But you know, we decided just to do this album, and I said, why not? What else have we got to do? We'll have a little fun. I know Joy enjoys it. So we each had two solos, and then the rest were all duets. And I thought it was a lot of fun, and I want to tell you something. You think you know music, you sing it, you hum it, you dance to it, it sounds great in your ears, but you really didn't know a thing about music until we spent the summer with these guys, and they were talking in their language, you know, chords and whatever the hell it is. Just really something. And I got the deepest respect for them and their talent. So thank you very much, Alan. John. And Marty.
Bob Mann.
Great New York musicians. And so Joy had a couple of great songs in there, one of which she sang, she remembers from a long time ago, right?
You're talking about It Could Happen to You?
Oh, and It Could Happen to You?
The Folks on the Hill. Yeah. It's an old song, but I've always loved it. And so we got to pick our own songs on this album, which was great.
And incidentally, the other song is a beautiful song, too, It Could Happen to You. It comes out of Going My Way with Bing Crosby.
I really
hate to keep
mentioning
Bing, but anyway, Bing, I'm thinking about you.
And we just chose a couple of old songs that some of you might remember. Thanks for the Memory. Oh, remember that?
Yeah, Bob Hope's theme song. But, you know, it's a combination of some fairly new songs, and Paul Schaefer. You see, Alan's studio is Big Don Records. It's right across the street, almost from the David Letterman studio. And so Paul was up there quite a bit, got kind of interested. We said, Paul, what do you think we should do? And Paul arranged and conducted and played on a great old Burt Bacharach song called
This Guy's in Love with You.
So that's the background of the whole thing. Now what do we do? John Hancock and some of the, well, be happy to do that. Do people come up here?
We'd like to meet some of you if you would like to come up.
Yeah, sure. Come on up, folks. We'll be happy to take a